Nina, the coach here. I am doing something a little different today. I'm going to send a little message of encouragement based on what I know to be true. A lot of times I back up my woo-woo stuff with science. There is some science to back up what I'm going to talk to you about today. But mostly, sorry about the sun. Mostly, if you've been following me, I hope that you trust me, and hopefully because you trust me, you'll take my word for my experience as gospel. That's a lot. It's a lot to ask, but the point is that I want to attempt to bring some comfort, and I want to open the door to people to whom I resonate with deeply on a spiritual level, because my purpose is to help you elevate and reach enlightenment and open that door to continued enlightenment. So let's hop right in. What do I know? I want to give you some encouragement and some peace about that death is not an end. Death is just a beginning. So for example, when you're a baby in your mother's womb, you didn't know what was just 2 inches away from you, a whole nother world. And it was a new beginning. You had your safe little comfortable world inside of her uterus. And then go through some trauma, and it's a whole new amazing world. And I know that that is what happens in death. I know that. Why do I know that? So when I turned 40, I started studying death and dying extensively. I read the Tibetan Book of Death and Dying, anything with Elizabeth Ross Kubel something. She's a renowned death expert. I read every book ever written, life after life, and any book ever written about near-death experiences, shared-death experiences, deathbed experiences. I read everything there is to find on quantum theory about the fact that we are made up of atoms and other molecules, and that it has been proven that all the particles created in a catastrophic event are connected, and thus proving that every action causes a reaction. So when you affect one particle, you affect all the other particles. Knowing all that stuff is pointless if you don't believe it and you don't feel it. And so in studying near-death experiences, it led me to DMT first, which is quite difficult to access. DMT is the chemical version of the plant medicine ayahuasca, and has been described to have a similar effect as a near-death experience. So I also was led to some meditation techniques that open the third eye that kind of mimic the same experience. Ultimately, giving you a peek into eternity, or giving you a peek into reality. How about that? So I started this journey to like kind of search out DMT, which is not easy to find, like I said. And then in my study, when I moved out to Arizona, much easier to access different types of healing plant medicines here, and finally found some fought with kidney problems his entire life, and he has had not one, but two near-death experiences in his battles with kidney failure and COVID and all this other stuff. Brother was intubated and is alive to tell about it. Amazing brother. His energy is like the sun. And it was just so amazing because in my study of near-death experiences, the only people that I've ever heard recount near-death experiences have been white people. So this was a brother, and it was just amazing. And representation is so much. And I had to talk to him, and I had to tell him thank you for being brave enough to tell his story, because depending on who you're telling it to, they might want to try to put you in a padded room. So I just appreciate him telling his story, and more than that, it's about the message that it brings. And I'm telling you all of this to bring you this message. I'm not here to talk about psychedelics for healing. I'm not here to talk about near-death experiences. I'm here to tell you that this is not it. This isn't it. I guess I've always steered the channel to more practical stuff, and I've not really leaned too deeply into mysticism. All these different beliefs that people have. I've never been trying to alienate anyone, and I'm still not trying to alienate you. I'm trying to bring you some comfort and let you know that this is not it. This is not it. And once you transition, absolutely everything is there, because we are everything. We are all made up of the same things. It is illusion that we are solid. It's an illusion of particles vibrating very fast that we are solid. It's an illusion. We're not solid. And the things that compose us are the same things that compose inanimate objects, non-living, non-carbon-based items on the earth. Everything. We make up everything. Everything in us, we are made of the same things. We're made of particles that came from the same catastrophic event. We are everything. So, one of the most beautiful sayings I've ever heard, and probably came from somewhere else, but I read it in The Secret, was if you ask a theologian what happens when you die, they'll say you go to God. And if you ask them what is the definition of God, they will say always has been, always will be, cannot be created or destroyed, constantly moving through form, in form, and out of form. If you ask a scientist what happens when you die, they'll say your energy changes form and you become a different part of energy. Well, what is energy? Well, cannot be created or destroyed, always has been, always will be, constantly moving through form, in form, and out of form. It's the same thing, God, energy, just with a different name, same definition, just a different name. So if we're made of energy, if we're made of God, that then goes to follow that we always have been and we always will be. We cannot be created or destroyed.
In a quarter mile, turn right onto Arizona 238 West, West Smith Anka Road.
Gotta get off of here soon. Constantly moving through form, in form, and out of form. So we are made of energy. We cannot be destroyed. We're just changing form. Find comfort in that. Kamina the coach sending you love, light, peace, and joy. I'm about to go skydiving.
Turn right onto Arizona 238 West.